All right, so my name is Jacob Weber, and I'm obviously a student in Physics 2212, and I'm going to be talking about the lecture that I attended last Monday, which was called The Origin of the Universe and the Era of Time. It was given by the Caltech professor, Sean Carroll, obviously a really smart guy. I do have some notes on my computer, which is right behind this, so I keep like looking up and down. That's why I just want to have some sort of structure to what I'm saying so that I just don't go totally off of topic and rant. So anyhow, his main focus for the lecture was talking about time and how we, you know, remember yesterday but we don't remember tomorrow, and then, you know, how we can turn an egg into an omelet but not an omelet back into that egg. And he kind of answered these questions that are just so intuitive and kind of ingrained in our head that we wouldn't even ever ask, but he answered them from a scientific perspective rather than just, well, that's just, you know, the way it is. And so because he was able to answer it from a scientific perspective, it was really interesting. And so we did so through the second law of thermodynamics, which is specifically talks a lot about entropy, which basically just states that everything trends towards disorder. And so, of course, you can turn an egg into an omelet because that's going from a lower entropy state to a higher entropy state. But you can't turn an omelet back into an egg because you can't go from higher entropy to lower entropy. And that's just how the universe works, basically. And so obviously he talked a lot more about that. But that was the general gist of his lecture, and it was kind of used to explain a lot of these sort of, you know, quote-unquote simple questions from a more higher level of thinking. So in terms of something that I learned that I found interesting and that I can teach you, the viewer, is the relationship between entropy and complexity. Because prior to going into the lecture, I assumed that, you know, because I had kind of an idea of what entropy was, and of course I knew what complexity was, and so I assumed that entropy with, you know, as things get more disorderly, because they trend towards disorder, things will also get more complex. And however, that's not true. The actual relationship between these two things is whereas, as entropy constantly goes, towards disorder, you know, just linearly goes toward disorder, complexity is more of a bell curve. And so it goes towards disorder, so it's the most, or it goes towards complexity. So it's the most complex kind of in the middle. And then at the end, it becomes simple again. So at the, let's say at the start of the universe, you know, you had the lowest entropy state of all time. And then since then, it has been continually going up. And also at the start of the universe, as at least so far, you had the most simple state. And it has been going up. But then at the end of the universe, you know, if we can imagine that, you will have the most, the highest entropy state. However, it'll be back to simplicity. And so the example that he used in his lecture to kind of explain this was he took a glass and filled it with coffee, and or he took a picture, but it was a glass filled with half coffee and then half creamer. And they weren't actually coffee and creamer. He used, it was something like water and oil because they split perfectly, but you had, you know, you had your coffee here, your black coffee, and then your white creamer on top. And so that was, at the beginning, it was both the least entropy and the least complex. So it was very simple. And then, you know, you start to stir it and you kind of see the creamer mixing in with the coffee. There's swirls, it's more complex, and it's also higher level of entropy. And then at the end, when you're totally done stirring and you just have this brown, lighter brown thing of coffee with creamer mixed in, it has the highest entropy because there are the most possible configurations. But it's also back to simple again. You know, it's not mixed in, it's very simple. So that was kind of interesting how complexity works more as a bell curve, and entropy works just linearly, continually goes up, increases over time. So that was something that I learned. Finally, the last thing was an idea that wasn't discussed by Dr. Carroll, but something that I would like to know more about. And that would be kind of following the same trend of entropy, the relationship between that and complexity. I'd like to know if there's any way to predict when we're kind of at that apex of complexity, when we're at the tipping point where it stops getting more and more complex. And when I say it, I just mean everything, the universe. When it stops getting more and more complex and starts getting more simple. And maybe we've passed that. I don't think so. I think we're still getting more complex. But that would be interesting if we could predict where that was in, you know, maybe push it all farther so that we can continue to get more complex, or just knowing that point would be really interesting. So that was it. I found the lecture really interesting. I looked at Dr. Carroll before. I had seen other public lectures on YouTube and listen to him in different speeches and debates that he had done. So I was really excited to go, and he's definitely a really great speaker. So yeah, that's all I have. Thanks.